Right, good morning everyone. For any of you who were unable to make it yesterday, my name is Arpit Nascom, the Center of Excellence for IoT. And welcome today to at Telematics Day 1, so the launch of the magazine Future of Mobile, which was co-published by the Center of Excellence for IoT and Telematics as well. We had a lot of great talks, we have had a lot of great panel discussions as well, and we can process it. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our first speaker, Mr. Jeffry, who is the principal at Roland Berger. Jacob has over 16 years of experience in industry and consulting. His main industry is focused on automotive and industrials. Prior to joining Roland Berger, Jeffry was principal in Tata Strategic Management Group in India. He has also previously held positions in India and overseas at GE, ICICI, Toyota, and Nexus in the areas of corporate strategy, finance, Six Sigma, and business development. He completed his degree in mechanical engineering, followed by master's in management studies from Jamnagar Bajaj Institute of Management Studies in Mumbai. Please give it up for Mr. Jeffry.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Passenger vehicles
whether it's a VW, whether it's Audi, whether it's BMW. So that's typically where the initial penetration is taking place. But that's also the case for most of technology. It always, in some cases, starts in aerospace or defense, but and then moves on to automotive. And even automotive moves on from higher end and slowly starts dramatically increasing in the lower end vehicles as well. When we look at the GM OnStar, which is widely used, again, you have subscription based communications, you have hidden vehicle security, stolen vehicle slowdowns, widely used in US, Canada, China, Brazil, Argentina, Mexico. And these are also eligible for insurance systems. So these are models which are slowly making its way into India, and Australia is coming here going forward. Today, the largest share is by EMEA regions. Going forward, it's expected to be APAC, which is a major driver. The largest, again, has been driven in fleet management, customer relationship management, and navigation support. One of the major reasons why EMEA also leads is because of legislation and because of regulations. When you talk about the e-call driver safety project, that's primarily where they found that after a crash or an accident, when people call back to the police or the fire brigade, for instance, sometimes even the location is not right, the description is not right. So this is, after a crash, a standard message in a European format would be sent with the location to the public safety awareness system, which is an automated, which is a call center for ambulance, the cops, fire brigade, and then based on what is the appropriate response, the decision will be made, and thereby being standardized and also saving time and lives. Going forward, APAC is expected to be an emerging market. One major reason for the growth of CV telematics is also because of the opportunities that are limited for OEMs today. OEMs need to move beyond the traditional, manual. They need to move beyond new vehicle sales and look at more areas where you can extend your coverage of the value chain and look at more profit pools. And connectivity offers that. When you look at the transportation value chain, new vehicle sales, whether it's today or after 20 years, will offer a limited and the same amount of margins. But in other areas where you have connectivity solutions through diagnostics and through management or through monetizing operations, you will see a large amount of profit pool being eaten up by the OEMs and by other service providers. This is for strengthening your after-sales business, increasing your customer retention, as well as to serve an existing customer demand. So you have OEMs who want to now position themselves as full service providers. You have logistics services who want tailored solutions like fleet vehicle operation models. And you have logistics companies who need the capacity and cost flexibility, especially when you have demand volatility and also businesses which are increasing going forward. So you have solutions today across the value chain, which spans vehicle management, load monitoring, cargo management or time management, legal management, as well as driver and logistics management. In India, when you look at it, the commercial vehicle market is less than half a percent of the global telematics market. And this is specific to the commercial vehicle market which I'm talking about, because India is largely driven, even today, by the commercial vehicle market. It's expected to grow going forward at over 20%, and this is driven by your vehicle safety, cargo safety. You have a significant amount of transit losses. Over 10% of logistics costs are transit losses today, in addition to beverage of your another beverage cost. You have business models where you have professionalized cargo solution and cargo transportation companies coming as a result. They need a proper tracking and monitoring system. If you look at Vivigo, their entire business model is also built on the fact that you can track, you can monitor, and you can turn around the vehicle at each of these pit stops much faster. And there's also policy support from the government for preventing accidents and for preventing any untoward incidents in vehicles. In terms of equipment, we are still largely an aftermarket driven country. Over 80% is aftermarket and around 70% is entry level and which is basic, low cost, and in many cases even Chinese standards. The penetration in commercial vehicles is around 4% today, and going forward is expected to almost double to around 9% by 2020. Various offerings, of course, starting from basic fleet tracking to mid-tier where you have vehicle management, moving on further to vehicle maintenance and operations, and finally with a wide range of monitoring and analysis. Today, the small fleet size, pricing, and inadequate infrastructure are key barriers to adoption. In terms of size, what we have is almost 75% of our fleet is less than 20 In terms of price, logistics companies already operate on wafer-thin budgets. Asking them to put in more money into something on which the ROI is not very clear in terms of pricing becomes a challenge, which is why we largely have a high penetration of lower-end or value-based products. In terms of infrastructure, we have another challenge. In infrastructure, we have an advanced level of connectivity. When we are talking about entertainment, diagnostics, and there are parts in the country where trucks go, where even service coverage of mobile service coverage is not adequate. So these three areas need to be, of course, tackled. And it is expected that with GST and increasing professionalization of logistics service providers and services, there will be an even more wider adoption of telematics. In terms of the hardware market share, we can split it into four major players. The first are the international players like Trimble, who cater to large corporate customers, but limited penetration in the mass market of small fleet customers. Then you have the large OEMs, whose share is today small, but that's one of the areas that is expected to increase dramatically going forward, because they will look at this as additional maximization of monetization potential. Then you have the Indian non-OEMs, which are large public or private sector customers, and then the Chinese players, who have typically primitive web solutions and robust devices, a significant share of the volume, but a relatively smaller share in terms of value. All OEMs are there in India today, and all of them are offering telematics, but the penetration in terms of the telematics is still limited. On the other hand, you have diversified companies and competencies coming in today. Whether it's manufacturing of hardware, screens, controls, interfaces, whether it's the software, operating systems, to HMI or IBI, or through connectivity, hardware and software, which is your SIM cards, Wi-Fi, or through prepaid and postpaid offerings and subscriptions to start. And finally, at the end, you have data processing, which primarily looks at the knowledge generation and then creation of apps and software. And that's the reason why today you have a large number of players who typically weren't in the automotive space earlier. The OEMs and suppliers are traditionally always there, and they reinforce this relationship further to optimizing vehicle design, offering new features. Then you have the internet and the device manufacturing companies, which is now extending the mobility way of life to vehicles and other universes. You have operators and you have infrastructure providers and service providers who are consolidating their position and influencing the intelligence systems to play and be a significant part of this new area. When you look at companies like Amadeus.com, it's a French car insurer and it's a pay as you like kind of scenario. With Toyota, it's again, you have information on speed limits, you have information on the traffic hazards, you have information on the traffic conditions, and you already have more than 5 million users way beyond that in Europe as well. This means you typically have to look forward towards new alliances. We have insurance companies tying up with navigation and emergency call system providers to get access to driver data. Privacy becomes a concern in many countries and more also in India to that extent. You have network giants like Google who can then tomorrow start sponsoring mobile internet access on the vehicle in return for the information that they are capturing. And they already have a significant amount of information. You have new roles for automotive companies which become software developers. Telecom companies now becoming automotive suppliers and data transfer channels. And you have hardware companies like auto telematics who focus on usage-based insurance products to reduce losses for insurance companies and complete management, etc. So you become analytics providers. It's different from the traditional automotive industry because unlike a normal product development cycle of 5-6 years, here the speed is much larger. You need to align yourself, and even if you're an OEM providing these solutions, you have to compete with people whose core business is providing telematic solutions. And these development cycles are much faster than what's typically there in the car manufacturers. At the same time, you also have the telematics market evolving. You have demand for cloud-based data for scalability, for data storage and reduction of complexity. You have government legislations, the Solar 2030 initiative, where they said by 2070 you would have 100,000 buses, which would be all fleet management would be done. But STUs are today in really debatable shape in most cases. So, how much of investment they can afford to do in all this will depend on the financial health of the STU and the support of the central government. You have increasing collaborations and partnerships by Sekara Motors with Microlist will be the data feedback platform, so you will have these increasing collaborations. You have many OEMs tying up with core manufacturers. And you're focused on value-added products, for instance, speech recognition features while driving so that it's easier to drive. Some of the opportunities that open up because of this in terms of connectivity solutions, you can leverage the communication technologies and enable machine-to-machine communications to still be various AIs, sensors, whether it's driver assistance, parking assistance. Parking assistance is one that is widely used in lane departure warning systems and so on. In terms of data processing, or that you have data which you collect, whether it's driver data, vehicle data, or environment data. And your combination of service modules pertaining to navigation, to diagnostics. And you have content providers which provide all these relevant data from users to vehicles and also can distribute this to various players in the field. IT services look at information management and cybersecurity solutions. Now, when you look at the hardware and software part within this connectivity solutions, it's almost 50-50 today. Today, it's easy to manage it. The hardware, for instance, from 48 million to 185 million, growth of 22%. And this includes onboard, offboard units as well as any other associated interfaces, whether it's machine to machine communication. Now, here, there's also a significant potential in terms of manufacturing and producing embedded systems, sensors for these various facilities. Today, you have the largest application of driving awareness sensors in these low cost parking assist sensors. And sometimes you have to couple to the camera, sometimes you have to couple to the money buses. But this starts somewhere as well as 500 rupees and go up to 2,000 rupees. Chinese sensors and buzzer kits have been running in the market for these parking sensors. In the advanced sensor technologies, they are largely absent in India. And also the cost is significantly higher. Moving on to the services side, again, it's an important component, almost 20% of the share, and expected to grow at 25% with almost 134 million by 2022. And this excludes the additional potential which can be there from passenger vehicles, aircrafts, and so on. Some of the examples here are the ones we discussed earlier, which is analytics, services for diagnostics, fleet management, pure optimization, and infotainment and maintenance services. The growth of services significantly in the data processing and the services side. And future insurance, if you look at it, one of the examples which is there in pay as well, etc., is you have few data points that are being refreshed every year. From here, you move on to over 1,000 data points recorded every single day. And therefore, the existing actual experiences are a little help for these kind of models when you go into the future. Google works together with Ford to optimize the power plant usage, improve energy efficiency, and it's a subscription based model. You have Google, you have the OEMs, and you have the users who are the various players in these models. In India, while activity is limited, there have been few efforts. These are just some examples. There are a lot more. Track and tell with safety solutions, whether it's immobilizers, the geofencing, or for auto-speeding alerts. You have Car IQ, which helps in the various analysis and data of car conditions, driving patterns, and offers you maintenance-related solutions. You have the Raksha or Safe Ride, which again is on emergency-related. You have smart panic buttons, and you have a 24/7 center as well for coordinating emergency services. So these content service providers also form an integrated part of this overall ecosystem. In terms of providing content, again, we have had limited players in India, but some of the initiatives and the reason for this also is content is you have a lot of things which are available on your smartphone, and these are also competing with a lot of devices. Google Maps has started availabilizing the past month, if you have noticed as well, and that, while it's already popular, that also eats into some of the other paid subscription models, and they have to obviously be on their toes to offer something which the customer is not willing to pay for in addition. MapMy India has introduced interactive and social media, whether it's editing a place, writing reviews, and so on. Automated like navigations have, I mean, they show you your points of interest, and Car IQ, MapMy India also analyze driving patterns and so on. But the challenges still are in terms of low customer demand because of pricing, because of the awareness. In terms of lack of standards or limited clarity, which is the best model? Is it a one-time use? Is it a pay-as-you-go? If so, what's the split between the two? Or it's a mix of both? And the high volume of data, particularly given India's breadth and its size, scale also becomes a major factor. And one of the last options is today you're moving from the old fat lines or the PCUs which had local storage and dedicated security, and their software for the PC server, the focus was always on endpoint security or protection. We also have a lot of these wireless software also used on endpoint software for the same reason. But going forward, in the future, it's going to be all interconnected devices. Everything moves to the cloud. So security cannot be at one point. It has to be all across and become an integral part of the network. Service providers like Infosys today are already working with CAGR to manage its global data centers, including data collected from the collected from these connected cards. So that's mainly what I had. Since the market is on a nascent stage, multiple opportunities exist, of course, today. You have parking solutions where you have a Bangalore-based startup, which had started off sometime back in terms of finding parking slots, booking parking slots in advance, etc. You have entertainment while driving, Volkswagen introduced the ideal edition in which you could have real live stream feed of the cricket matches at that time on your car, because typically you spend over 1.5 hours driving to office and from office to home every day. So, well, thought through positioning of products, of connectivity solutions, whether it's products or services, become critical to succeed in the Indian market. The things which we have to look at is one, the range of functions. Which you are defining in these solutions. What are the system characteristics? What's the geography that you are planning to target? Is it going to be just restricted to India or regional? What's the scope of these applications? And finally, what's the pricing model that will give us the most volumes for the money that we invest and the money that we get from it?